Well, we're back here at HIMSS 2019 here at the UiPath booth with another use case for healthcare. I have David with me to show us insurance and eye care. And what are we showing?
Yeah, so what we're doing here is we're logging into an insurance provider that's like for eye care. So think of like VSP, vision insurance, where they have to log in, do a claim and all that. So I'm gonna go ahead and start this up. This is just a video, I'm gonna walk you through it. First thing I wanna show you is how when we create different modules, we're gonna be, here's a login piece, here's the claim piece, here's the claim summary. Reason why we do that is we want to sometimes reuse these over and over again.
Okay, right? So these are different kind of pieces of the automation
Correct.
That you segment it out.
Exactly. I have not so seen you might have A, B, C, and D, and you go, you know what, A, we might reuse over and over again, B, we might reuse over again. The information is always there so that you can rinse and repeat some of the stuff and reuse your code.
New thing, I have not seen this. This is good. I'm learning something every day.
So basically in this case, it's gonna go ahead and run. It's gonna walk you through a little bit of it. It's gonna show you the different pieces. As you can see by our layout, what it's gonna do. In a second, it's gonna go ahead and roll and run it. All right, so but again, you have login, insurance claim, read summary, you
name it. So if I look at that right, am I actually logging into four different kinds of systems at that point or four different platforms?
It's not so much four different systems, but so four different pieces of the pie, if that makes sense. All right, so in this case, there he's actually clearing the queue, making sure it comes back to the screen. They're actually gonna be logging in. Okay, at this point, he's gonna go ahead and he's actually, in this case, logging into two different systems in this case. One is the login for the iMed, one's gonna be the insurance, and he's gonna be linking them together to take information from one and put it in the other.
Just like a person would do.
Just like a person would do, exactly.
So really pushes our HIMSS interoperability message that we're trying to push to everybody.
So basically, he logged on two different systems. Now he's filing a claim, and this is where they're logging back in to see what the status of the claim is.
Okay.
All right. And so basically in this case, they're basically calling the claim status. They can go ahead and sort by 2 weeks, 3 weeks, a month, you name it, and basically see what of the outstanding claims are available. So as a provider, like if you're an eye care provider, this is something you're gonna be doing all the time to say, what's the status of all my claims?
Yeah.
What are we waiting for? So in this case, we're going great. Here, this is outstanding for still needs SSN, right?
Yeah.
And so someone automatically, in this case, a robot's gonna be going, needs SSN. It might be kicking off an email to somebody to say, hey, go call client and get SSN, things like that.
So again, and I can just keep running this over and over again without having to have a human in this process. So
this is an unattended robot always running in the background. So it's always updating the claim status, logging in to file a claim, and also find out what the claim status is. Again, in this case, we're logging into two different systems, and at the end, we're creating an Excel sheet to say, here's a report for the office manager. Here's where we're at with all the claim status, which is very important.
Yeah, and this saves a lot of time, I'm assuming.
Not only that, but they could be basically looking at that Excel sheet and just look at it from there, from that Excel sheet, we could create a whole chart to say, hey, for some reason, Jody, when she logs in people, there's always errors. So maybe it might be like, hey, we need to retrain Jody in the front desk to make sure she gets information, a lot better information front end.
Now, how did you create this? We have Studio, looks pretty complicated. How, in creation this, how complex was this from a creation point of view?
Yeah, from a creation standpoint, it's pretty easy. We're going to activities, so it might be here, we're going to do login. So we're gonna create a sequence that says login, and there we're gonna be going, doing a one-step click, and so then we can use a recorder, do a selector, and say, here's the login, click on it. It's really plug and play. It's really simple. You don't need to be a developer to do this. You just need to know what the existing human process is and then go from there.
So you're the person who knows the processes. You've been doing these processes for a long time. Now we're just bringing in and automating it into the system.
Absolutely.
Thank you, David. Thank you, guys. We'll be back with you the rest of the week. So continue to follow.